significant about that report from RBC Capital that showed that marketers, they prefer going on Facebook?
Yeah, I mean, I think there's been a lot of concern about Facebook as a platform for success for advertisers, both brand advertisers and conversion-driven commerce advertisers. But not just a year ago, but if you can see the last 4 months, Twitter has really turned their biggest challenge into their biggest asset, which is mobile. If you look now, north of 40% of their revenue is mobile, which is astounding compared to 15 months ago.
So how did that happen? What's the change here?
A lot of it, I think, comes from the top. I think the leadership had said, let's move from being a desktop platform to a mobile platform. So that's literally all you hear Facebook talk about. I think it's very smart because the transition from desktop to mobile is happening much, much faster than I think anyone has ever been able to predict.
Twitter, how big of a chance or an opportunity is there for Twitter here on mobile advertising? And in fact, maybe to outpace Facebook at some point?
Well, we'll see. I mean, Twitter obviously in terms of maturity is behind Facebook, but Twitter, north of 60%+ of their consumption is mobile. So if you look at their revenue and they're purported to be a south of a $1 billion company in revenue, mobile will be huge for them. And I think mobile is really going to be the story for revenue for Twitter going forward as they go to IPO this year or early next year.
But do advertisers find that they're very influential at all when they go on these platforms? Do they just feel like they need to be in these platforms because they need to be there?
Well, I mean, the numbers don't lie. Facebook's north of a billion users globally. Twitter has north of 200+ million registered users. So the audiences are extraordinarily large. Plus, I think mobile is really proving that it works. At our company, ShareThrough, we're seeing incredible conversion on mobile, incredible interaction rates on mobile.
When
that
you
far
say
outpaced
conversion,
desktop.
What are we talking about?
We're talking about someone clicking to sale. So if you look at Twitter, the promoted tweet is the unit that they most prescribe to advertisers, and that promoted tweet can both drive brand and conversion. Conversion being if eBay was to advertise or The Gap, et cetera, a person clicks on that ad and actually buys a product.
Is that more that you see on mobile than you've seen on desktop?
Not necessarily more. I think you've seen mobile as a little bit of a laggard in terms of performance for buying. Most people are buying on desktop, but as much as user consumption is moving to mobile, I think commerce behavior will move to mobile as well.
But Patrick, here's the thing, right? I mean, it's easy for advertisers to look at an event like the Super Bowl, for instance, and they know that they're going to get 100 million plus eyeballs if they put a commercial during the Super Bowl. You know, it's sort of one blast, and they know that they're going to get that capacity. But how do they find that out? How do they know that? Where is that same analogy when you start going on mobile and you start, you advertise on Facebook or Google or wherever?
The sort of instant global reach that you'd see in the Super Bowl can't be really reached on par in terms of online.
It can never be?
Well, not at this point. Yahoo's homepage on a given moment, Google's homepage on a given moment, which doesn't sell advertising, you can see reach to a specific moment in time. But if I'm an advertiser, I want to take an always-on approach, and I want to think of marketing not in momentary glimpses a la the 3 hours of the Super Bowl in February, but instead to reach a consumer wherever they might be, and whether it's mobile, desktop, tablet, to have an always-on approach for a marketer is the way to go.
And just finally, Patrick, I mean, you hear so much, though, about as these platforms are going towards more ad revenue, that they may turn off their base, their core base of customers. Have you seen evidence of that, or is that overblown?
I think that's a little bit overblown. I think it's concern for the old desktop where you see banners and interruption and pre-play autoplay
advertising.
Really annoying. But I think when you look at Twitter, Facebook, and even our platform at ShareThrough, we look at native advertising, which is in-feed, takes the form and function of the particular site. This is the sponsored story unit on Facebook. It's the promoted tweet
like
on Twitter.
Like paid advertisements in a magazine.
Exactly. Or even search. These are native ads that fill the experience in a much better way than interruption does.